Towards Lamune from Thansing, Prekchu flows by your left. Here, the gushing of Prekchu, but could hardly see any of the mountains in such dark. By 3:05 a.m., we were at Lamune, and by 5:30 a.m. almost, we were at viewpoint 1. Trekkers who go to Guechala are only allowed to venture up to the first viewpoint near Chemathang Plateau. The actual Guecha Pass is at the third viewpoint. Kanchenjunga means the five great treasures of snow. In Tibetan, Gangs or Kang means snow. Chen means great. Jon means treasure. And Inga means five. The area around Kanchenjunga is said to be home to a mountain deity called Zonga or Kanchenjunga demon. It is a type of yeti or rakshas. The rumor is a British geological expedition back in 1925 spotted a bipedal creature which they asked the locals about, who referred to it as the Kanchenjunga demon. Local Lopo people or the Bhutias believes hidden treasures reveal themselves to the devout when the world is in peril. This treasure comprises of salt, gold, hydrated phosphate, precious stone, sacred scriptures, invincible armors, ammunition, grain, medicines, and whatnot. Kanchenjunga's name in the Limbu language is Senjen Lugma or Sheshe Lugma. It is believed to be the abode of an omnipotent goddess called Yuma Samang. In English, Yuma Samang means Mother Earth or Grandmother. Samiti Lake is an alpine freshwater lake, locally called Bunmoteng Cho or Sungmoteng Sho. Water into this lake comes from Mount Panlim, which is right by its side, and the outlet goes on to the Prekchu, which later joins to Rathongchu. For the return journey from Thansing to Shoka, the route changes at Kokchuram to bypass Zongri via a left-side trail through a dense jungle with steep descents in some places. The route seems like an S-shaped jungle with occasional mud patches and some small water crossings in between. After Fedang, it is all steep descents with rhododendron lining all the way down to Shoka. Returning Yuksum from Shoka is mostly downhill. Now, the excitement of onwards journey for exploration gets dethroned by a sense of melancholy. Just before reaching Pakhola, the gate of Kanchenjunga National Park bids everyone adieu, saying thank you for your visit. Back in 1903, Douglas Freshfield wrote about Kanchenjunga. In the first awestruck moment of beholding, embodied spirits of overwhelming power and malignity. They have been fearfully searched by winds that mark the course in sweep of the wrinkled drifts and all the scars and lines run downwards, giving the mountain an infinitely cheerless and depreciating expression, like a sad, worn face. Till next time, goodbye.